click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to see what is 1's complement method. So in today's video, we are going to see how the binary subtraction is performed using the 1's complement method. 1's complement method is nothing but in this method, you can perform the subtraction by using the binary addition method. So there are different kind of rules and there are different kind of set of steps using which you can perform the 1's complement subtraction. So let's start with the 1's complement subtraction. So we have so far we have seen the binary addition and the subtraction rule. Now we are going to see what do you mean by the 1's complement subtraction method. So I am going to tell you the different steps to perform the subtraction. The step number 1 is to find out the binary of number A. Suppose you have the two numbers, that is number A and the number B. The first step will always be to find out the binary of number A. Okay. Now we have two numbers, that is A and B. So in this case my first number will be A and my second number will be B. Let's take an example. The value of A is 10 and the value of B is 15. So first number will be 10 and the second number will be 15. So in the first step you will find out the binary of 10. Okay, now let's see the next step. In the second step, find out the 1's complement of B. In our case, the second number is 15. So what we will do is, we will find out the 1's complement of 15. So this is B. So in the second step, we will find out the 1's complement of B. Now let's see the third step. In the third step, what we have to do is, we have to add the step number 1 and step number 2. But in the first step, what we have got the binary of A. That means you will add the binary of number A. And in the second step, you have got 1's complement of B, that is 1's complement of 15. So in the second step, 1's complement of 15. So the binary of A and the 1's complement of 15, you will add in the step number 3. Okay. Now this step 4. The step 4 plays a very important role. Because from the step 4, you will be able to know whether your answer is positive or negative. So in the binary, how you will identify whether your answer is positive or negative? So there is one trick over here. Now watch carefully. We have two numbers, means we have assumed as an example two numbers, that is number 10 and number 15. Okay. So in the normal decimal subtraction, if you subtract the number 10 from 15, what you will get? You will get the minus 5. Okay. So in the decimal, you are able to know how to give the minus sign. That is when we are subtracting the small number, when we are subtracting the big number from the small number. So here also, we have one trick using which we can identify whether our binary subtraction is positive or negative. So from the step number 3, you will get the answer, that is of addition of step number 1 and 2. Okay. Now in step number 4, what you are going to do is, if carry 1 is present, like suppose you have 4 digits of binary like this, 1010. Okay, after step number 3, you have got this as an answer, that after addition of 2. And suppose this 1 carry is present. Okay, so this is the extra 1. Okay, if the carry 1 is present, then what you have to do is, then your answer is positive. Okay. Now, using this trick, you can identify whether your answer is positive or negative. So, if the after the addition, after the step 3, if you got the carry, that means your answer is positive, okay? And if the carry is absent, that means your answer is negative. Suppose this 1 is not present over here. So, that means your answer is negative. But how to write the means final correct answer? This step won't give you the final correct answer, okay? We have to find out the final correct answer. This step only gives us the information whether our answer is positive or negative. Now, if your answer is positive, you have to make the end around carry. And if your answer is negative, that means if the carry is absent, you have to find out the 1's complement of that particular value that you got from step number 3. Now, what do you mean by the end around carry? In end around carry, what you do, if the carry is present, you simply add this carry in this answer. So what you will get, 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 as it is, 0 as it is, and 1. So this will be your final answer. This is just an example. This is not the subtraction of 10 and 15. I have just taken the example and the this values. Okay. So if you got the carry as 1, that means your answer is positive. And the final correct answer you will get after making the end around carry. And end around carry means adding 1 into that. Okay. Now, what if the carry is absent? Suppose this carry is not present here. We have only got 1010 value. Then our answer is negative. But this is not the final corrected answer. For this, again, we have to find out the 1's complement of that answer. Suppose we have got 1010 in the step number 3 and the carry is absent. That means our answer is negative. And we have to find out the 1's complement of number. And what do you mean by the 1's complement? 1's complement is simply replacing 0 by 1's and replacing 1 by 0's. So that means if 0 is present, we will replace the 0 by 1. And if the 1 is present, we will replace the 1 by 0. Now again 0 is present. Now to find out the 1's complement, what we will do is, we will replace this 0 value by 1. And again, if 1 is present, we will replace this value by 0. Okay. So this is the important step. If you write down the answer in the step number 3 only, then you won't get the answer as right, okay? You have to see whether your answer is positive or negative, and then only you can verify it. To verify the answer, what you can do is, first of all, just perform the addition or subtraction in the decimal, and after, if you are getting the answer, convert this final answer binary number again into the decimal, so that you will be able to know whether your answer is right or wrong. Now let's take an example of 9 minus 5 over here, okay? Here what you have to do is, you have to perform the binary subtraction, and we will perform the binary subtraction using 1's complement method. So let's start the step by step, okay? First step. What was the first step? First step was to find out the binary of A, okay? Here we have two numbers, so assume this number as A and this number as B, okay? So according to the first step, we have to find out the binary of A. So what is the binary of 9? The binary of 9 is 9. Okay, now the second step. In the second step, we have to find out the 1's complement of B. So here our second number is 5. So to find out the 1's complement of 5, first of all, we have to convert this decimal number into the binary. So what is the binary conversion of 5? So the conversion of 5 is 0101, okay? Now what we have to do is, in the step number 3, we have seen that we have to add the step number 1 and step number 2. But in the step number 2, we have to find out the 1's complement of B, that is the second number. So here we have just find out the binary conversion of 5. Now to find out the 1's complement of 5, we will just replace 1 by 0 and 0 by 1. So this is the 1's complement. Now let's start with the last stage. This stage is very important. In this stage, we have to add the step number 1 and 2. So in the step number 1, we have seen 1001, and from the step number 2, we have got the 1's complement of 5. Now let's do the addition. 1 plus 0 will give us 1, 0 plus 1 will give us 1, 0 plus 0 will give us 0, and in the binary addition, we have seen that 1 plus 1 will always give us a 0 and the carry will be 1. So okay, here how you will identify whether the carry is present or not. Here we have the 4 digit and here also we have the 4 digit. But after answer, we have got the 5 digit. Okay, so if 1 is present, that means the carry is present. Now, in the step number 4, we have seen if the carry is present. If the carry is present, we have to make the end around carry. And end around carry means we have to add this carry in the answer. So what we will do is, we'll make the end around carry, okay? So we will add this 1 into this answer. So 1 plus 1 will give 0, carry will be 1. And again 1 plus 1 will give us 0, carry will be 1. And this 0 plus 1, 1 and 0. Now let's see. So now this is our final answer. But to verify this answer, let's see. 9 minus 5 in decimal will give us 4. Okay. Now what we will do to verify this answer, we will convert this binary number into a decimal number. So let's convert this number. So 1, 2, 4, 8, these are the weightages. So from the weightages, you can see we have got this answer as 4. Therefore, in the binary subtraction, we have got this value as 0100. Thank you friends for watching today's video. Today we have seen how do we perform the 1's complement method. Also different kind of method to perform subtraction we are going to see in the next video. So stay tuned to Ekeeda channel to watch the latest video.